So there are several areas that is being considered if a researcher put himself into unethical practices, okay, in research. Number one, harm to participants, of course, okay? So essentially, the real goal of the research ethics is to protect the human participants. Now, if there is unethical practices, of course, you put into harm your participants. Number two, it compromises research integrity. Okay. Nawawala ng halaga or nawawala ng integridad yung pinaka-research mo. And that impacts the research community. Actually, for us professionals who are involved in researches and who are known in research, okay, very important yan yung pinaka-research integrity. Number three is undermining public trust, of course. We have experienced that there are several journals or articles recently that has been publishing fraud data. Okay, say for example, during COVID-19, a lot of data that has been released. However, some are fabricated. And the consequences of that is, of course, the journal publisher do not stop from scrutinizing, especially it's a new topic, right? Some researches that has been published immediately were recanted, and that has an impact sa mga authors. Usually, pag nag-submit ka doon sa ibang publisher or sa ibang journal article, naka-markup ka. Okay, parang credit card yan eh, no? Pagka marami kang utang, okay, naka-markup yung name mo. And so therefore, mahirapan ka mag-publish ng other papers. Okay? Another is it has a legal consequences. Just like I've said, ang research ethics is subsumed sa data privacy, which has had a legal impact. I'm not a lawyer, but if one violates, okay, the human rights of a person, that has a legal impact. Okay? Another repercussion is in terms of funding. If you do unethical practices, usually funders, tumatalikod sa'yo yan. Hindi ka nakakakuha ng mga funder. Kasi yung mga funder, magkakakilala yan eh. Okay? So, when you are tagged as parang blacklist as a researcher, mahirap kang kumuha ng funding. Eh, paano kung you need it? Okay? So, yun yung consequences. Another one is stifling scientific progress. A good research is a continuous research. Yun yung cycle. Kasi yung mga researcher, they read recommendations, di ba? From that recommendation, pwedeng mag-come up ng new research. Ngayon, kung fabricated or mayroong tinge ng falsehood yung mga results mo, paano yun magiging continuous? Or sometimes, they would create an article that would recant yung credibility mo as a researcher and a writer. Okay? Another is professional relationships. Mahirap yon. Okay? Walang makikipag-collaborate sa'yo. Okay? Ng mga other researcher, lalo na kung alam na may tinge ka, okay, ng falsehood ng mga data na nire-release mo. Okay? Parang mga doktor yan eh, okay? Us, as a researcher, as a scientific researcher, as a scientist, we have a group, of course, and pinag-uusapan namin yan, di ba? So, may repercussion siyan sa professional relationship. Another is erosion of research culture. Okay? In terms of global repercussions, if you release a data that is false, okay, mahirap yon. Research kasi is an evidence-based approach to a policy-making body. Paano kung false yung nirelease mo? How will you convince policymakers to adapt it? Yun.